This is Noir Alley, and I am your host, Eddie Muller. Every week, I bring you a representative example of film noir. But today, I'm presenting a film so singular, so weirdly ahead of its time, that it really isn't representative of anything, other than how unexpected and extraordinary a film can be when it's produced outside the mainstream and under the industry's radar. I'm talking about Gun Crazy, a film that barely caused a ripple on its original release in 1950, but is now recognized as one of the most dynamic and subversive movies of its day. Now, much of what's been written about Gun Crazy focuses on its director, Joseph H. Lewis, who shows off a brash and brilliant technique honed in the B-movie unit at Columbia Pictures. Now, Lewis gave many interviews over the years about this film, and like most directors, he took virtually all the credit for what makes this movie special. But I'm calling BS on you, Joe, having researched and written a book detailing the complete history of this movie, Gun Crazy, the origin of American outlaw cinema. I can attest that it's the result of an extraordinary collaboration, or perhaps a conflagration of artists, some of whom didn't even know they were working together. Now, the driving force behind Gun Crazy was producer Frank King, who with his brothers Maurice and Herman carved out a niche for themselves producing B-movies, mostly for lowly Monogram Pictures. Now, the King brothers inherited their business savvy from their bootlegger father, and in the business they were seen almost as crooks, bottom feeders, reviled by rivals who liked to flaunt their thin veneer of refinement and respectability. The Kings were hustlers, and they saw the picture business as a racket like any other. They liked making cheap genre pictures, and they always turned a profit. Well, after The Best Years of Our Lives dominated the Oscars in 1947, Frank King snapped up a short story written by that film's original author, McKinley Cantor. It was called Gun Crazy, and it told the story of a young boy fixated with firearms who became a hardened outlaw. The Kings were looking for a follow-up to their 1945 sleeper hit, Dillinger, and to have a big name like Cantor attached, well, all the better. The Kings even announced that Cantor would direct his own script. But after 2 years and five drafts, Cantor hadn't produced a script the Kings felt comfortable financing. Cantor's work was brilliant in parts, but unwieldy and often pretentious. So the minute Frank King learned that Dalton Trumbo, one of the infamous Hollywood Ten, was going to prison for contempt of Congress, he signed him up to salvage Gun Crazy. Well, desperate to earn cash for his family before being shipped off to jail, Trumbo took Cantor's rambling draft and streamlined it into a dizzying, almost surreal romantic saga, stuffed with sexual symbolism that taunted the censors in the production code office. Now, Joe Lewis did an exceptional job directing, but many of the film's most memorable sequences were scripted in vivid detail, both by Cantor and Trumbo. Now, how bizarre is it that McKinley Cantor, a hawkish anti-communist, died without knowing that it was Dalton Trumbo whose rewrite of Gun Crazy finally whipped it into filmable shape. Now, the character of Annie Laurie Starr is described in the script as a little prairie flower. And as late as 3 weeks before the start of shooting, the King's choice for the role was Veronica Lake. By then, however, Lake's drug and alcohol abuse was an open secret in Hollywood, and the Kings couldn't weather the risk. So super agent Charles Feldman suggested petite Irish actress Peggy Cummins, who literally was on her way back to the UK after a few dispiriting years in Hollywood that saw her discovered by Daryl Zanuck and then abandoned by him. And Peggy's performance, her Hollywood swan song, would galvanize the Gun Crazy production and earn her lasting fame as the tiniest but most ferocious femme fatale in the history of film noir. So are you ready? Then buckle up for a delirious 86-minute crime spree, as we are about to go completely gun crazy.